To survive in today's fast-changing and turbulent business environment, companies need to adapt to changing and competitive conditions. While the economy serves the waves of turbulence, the importance of risk management takes center stage. The increasing complexity and scope of the finance function has clearly brought upon the CFO other roles beyond controllership and compliance. To bridge the gap between growth needs and external demands with imminent reforms, CFOs have to balance traditional roles with more strategic inputs. Keeping this in perspective, Bloomberg TV India organized a CFO Conclave 2013 to create a platform for top business, finance, tax and accounting professionals to interact and share business impact, innovation of new business models, best practices and new frontiers. SK Sanga, General Manager, Union Bank, set the tone for the day by giving us an insight into the banker's perspective on the role of a CFO.
CFO's job description has never been so demanding. CFOs are expected to play diverse and challenging roles. Apart from having to continue to manage risks and costs, finance chiefs are now being expected to grow the business. In spite of challenging circumstances, CFOs are strategic assets for the organization, being actively involved in identifying the value, preparing for the scenario of unfavorable outcomes. While planning for the long-term bottom line, the CFO should build different what-if scenarios, identifying possibilities of what is going to happen. No one can predict the future exactly. There are too many different things that could happen to a business that will throw off the most sophisticated forecast. However, the CFO should identify the top scenarios of unfolding business environment and do what-if analysis on those identified scenarios. Accordingly, the likely flows under different constituents of the balance sheet can be worked out, and measurable goals can be broken down by quarter, month, or even by week. Thus, CFOs need having a clear vision and well-defined objectives that could be communicated throughout the organization. This helps to keep the organization's finances attuned to their wider goals and increase the value of finances in the eyes of the business.
What's the new normal? The new normal is one of volatility, undoubtedly. But are things improving on the ground when you actually talk to a lot of the companies that you lend to?
Yes, I will say that if we look at the overall position of the international economy, because with the more and more integration of our domestic economy with the international economy, there is a lot of impact which immediately gets transmitted to our economy. Mm-hmm. So we cannot be, you can say, anywhere different from the rest of the world economy, and the things overall in the world economies are also not that very, you can say, gloom, very encouraging as of now. But of course, since some time, the things have started improving, with the US economy also showing some signs of improvement, and the European economy is also getting a little bit stabilized. And that is having a cascading effect on our economy also. Mm. But at the same time, within our economy also, I'll feel that there are some uncertainties which have been happening till now, and as a result of which the new projects have not been coming up. And there was a lot of initiatives from the government which were required, but I'm happy to share that recently we had a meeting with the finance minister also, where it was clearly brought out the urgency to see that the projects which are stalled, we should give a push to those projects, and 176 projects have been cleared. So that is going to give a good positive, you can say, push to the economy as of now. So with that point of view, I'm quite optimistic that the things are going to improve for a better cause now. And as far as the things which have happened in the past on the in the shorter period, I'll say that things have been a little more volatile, and that makes the job of the CFO much more challenging. But that volatility also has to be seen not in a shorter period, but I think we need to look at it from the longer perspective.
Sure.
And from that perspective, I'll see that we are quite hopeful that the things are going to take a better shape as far as the international economy is concerned, and as well as our domestic economy is concerned.
Let me get Mr. Gupta into this. Mr. Gupta, a lot of your revenues come from the international markets, actually. We were just discussing that. My question to you is that what surprised many is that the turnaround in the international market, specifically US, has meant that a lot of export-driven companies are doing well. And if you look at the Sensex and the Nifty, it's really pharmaceutical and IT companies that are leading the rally. And I think we've seen a bit of green shoots appearing over there. So what is your own prognosis? Is the recovery out there here to stay? And are you seeing traction among your clients?
The key to succeed in that market environment is how to differentiate. And how do you convince the customer that you can still bring value, especially for technology companies like us? We try to see opportunities even in downturn, first of all. And second thing is that, yeah, we are seeing some green shoots. We see a better environment today, especially in America. But what we have seen over the period during all these 3-4 years of uncertainty, especially for IT industry, is that though the industry was faced with a different kind of a global challenge, but not every company was reacting in the similar manner. So during this period, you had seen companies performing better, and you had seen companies struggling to meet with the emerging scenario. I can give you a small example to elaborate on what I'm trying to say. You know, when all this meltdown started happening in 2008, and US was facing a big threat of recession, and automobile was a sector which was suffering a lot, and I had visited once Detroit, which was appearing to be a ghost town with a lot of layoffs and all that stuff was happening. And we do have got a lot of exposure in automobile sector through automation and embedded systems. We were quite worried because a sizable revenue we get from there. Then we try to reinvent ourselves, and you will be surprised that instead of reducing revenue from automobile sector, we were able to increase revenue from automobile sector.
So nimbleness is what is required to meet the uncertainty.
Yeah, second thing is that we talked about new normal. I think this uncertainty and risk is itself is a normal. There's nothing new about it. We have to just learn. Second thing is that there's nothing permanent on how do you address risk, because the nature of risk continues to change. So you have to be responsive to those changing nature of the risk. Risk will always be there. I think you can't have a business situation without risk.
The only thing is the risk is now more intangible as such. A lot of new risks have appeared in the horizon. Manoj, let me come to you. You do a survey of CFOs across geographies. What is the sense that you're getting from what you have heard from them, both in terms of the recovery and the new normal?
American Express, with the CFO research study, does an annual survey on spending and on spending monitoring. We polled in 2000, and this was the sixth such survey we carried out in 2013, quarter two of 2013, where we polled over 500 respondents across 20 countries across every geography, every continent in the world. I think the minimum threshold was a company with a turnover of less than, $500 million and above. So some very interesting trending or facets came out of that study. Let me start with optimism. What was shared with us was that the CFOs, and staying with India for a moment, the CFOs in India, this year, 78% of them believe that there will be expansion in the next 12 months. This number is down from 86% last
78%
year.
78% still believe there will be expansion?
That is correct. 78% of them believe that there will be economic expansion in the next 12 months. But it was 86% optimism, exactly a year ago, because we do the survey every year. The second interesting aspect was that in the past, people were sitting on the cash reserves. And this year, when I compare again the numbers, there was 32% of the respondents who last year said that they're going to dip into the cash reserves. This year, that number is up to 58%. The only country that is above us is China. So there is going to be a lot more of spending, a lot more of investment. The difference this year is around not how to do more with less, but it's about how to do more with same. So it's about how to do things differently. And that is where CFO as a value driver is going to play a role. So as a value driver, a CFO is going to be somebody who's going to be an advocate for growth. A CFO is going to be somebody who's going to be someone who embraces and actually encourages innovation and takes that through the organization. So that is what the CFO's role is likely to be in the times to come.
Hiren, somewhere down the line, I think the last 2-3 years and the kind of crumbling of the BRICS growth story has made a lot of big multinationals recalibrate their own expectations of what the emerging markets are likely to be. Tell me from your experience, when you talk to head office, is there a sense that perhaps, you know, it's not as easy a run as was expected earlier?
See, I think fundamentally from, if I speak about BRICS or emerging market, or specifically let's talk about India, I'm an optimist. I think the long-term story fundamentally is still pretty good, right? And but it is a recalibration given what's happening. And you know, I'm a little encouraged by what Manoj said, that 78% of the CFOs say that they're looking at expansion, more optimism, and also you are seeing more sense from CFOs that they're dipping into cash reserves to make investments. That's good. But you know, in the current environment, I also agree with you know, Mr. Gupta, that in the current environment, it's tough, and uncertainty and volatility is here to stay. That is the new normal. But I think what is in the recalibration that you're talking about, what it is about is looking in the current environment. It's super difficult though. You know, when you're not growing CAGR at 30, 40, 50% and you're growing at, you know, just struggling to make double digit growths in an environment where your expenses are still growing double digit, you know, whether it's your salaries or whether it's your rent and inflation is still high, we heard about it. So it's tough. It's super tough in calibrating a, you know, think about a P&L where your OPEX is growing really fast and you're challenged on the growth. So growth in my mind currently is really what is challenging. You know, we are not used to this environment. While, you know, it is the new norm probably, but you know, when you're coming out of 9, 9.5% India shining and you're struggling at about 5% GDP and people not growing. So it is tough. And in that environment, calibration is really about still betting for the future, looking at what you can do. Of course, everybody, all of us have to, you know, look at productivity and increasing efficiencies and driving efficacies. But it is really about rebalancing what we call as the P&L. Now, where do we spend less? Where can we really position ourselves to the growth lever of the future? You know, Mr. Gupta also gave a very interesting example. Where your revenue is challenged, you got to get creative. You got to get creative. His example about what happened in Detroit, but the revenue grew in spite of what was going. You got to rethink about how you're going to grow your revenue, how you're going to de-risk your revenue, and how you're going to still in that challenge P&L with OPEX is growing fast and you don't have the room, you probably de-invest somewhere to invest in the future because you got to still secure your future. And that's really about the calibration story from an emerging market.
Also in calibration of expectations from the Indian arms of MNCs, is there a recalibration
there? It is tough, but it is. It's a reality, right? And like you said, it is not only an India story, but you know, it is challenging from an emerging market perspective also the last couple of years. So right. I think yes, but it is still about recalibrating the expectation, but from a short-term perspective. Okay. Doing the right thing, so you're still setting yourselves up for success long-term.
Okay. Mr. Sangha, let's dip back to the survey and the findings out there. The numbers aren't really indicating that much of a positive spin on the ground, because I think they're stressed out sectors in like infrastructure and the capital goods space. And they are the sectors that are actually seeing a lot of the growth, which are really consumer facing, you know, and especially during this time of the year, there is a lot of traction out there. My question to you is that we also have a legacy of highly leveraged companies with big debt on their books. You have a situation where a lot of the expectations of rate decreases this year have not really fructified. So on the ground, what is the financial stress that you are sensing, and what is the role of the CFO? What are the challenges that CFOs face there?
You see, this is true that this kind of cash inflows which were expected in the corporates, those are not happening. And that has taken a hit on the expansion plans of the corporates also. And another factor is that our stock market is also is very volatile, and it has not been that consistent. And this is an atmosphere which has brought in a sort of little uncertainties as far as IPOs and FPOs are concerned. But looking to the atmosphere which is now prevailing, it is giving a sense of some positiveness, because the projects which were stalled, now I'm hopeful that those projects will come up. But at the same time, as being discussed here, that every stress brings out new opportunities.
Sure.
So that is an area where we look at that this is, instead of the going in for the project finances, this is the time for the bankers to look at the consumer finance and this mortgage finance, home loans. So that segment is still giving a lot of hope, and it's growing also. So this is there are the times to balance our, you can say, growth strategies, whether it is to be towards the high big ticket advances or towards the small ticket advances. So this is the time, I think, which is the time for the small ticket advances. But at the same time, banking has another dimension also, apart from the usual corporates concerns, concerns of the corporates. That is the management of the NPAs.
Alluded to the fact that the biggest challenge CFOs face is really managing cash flows in the short term and looking at investments in the long term. And somewhere it is that balancing act that requires a lot of dexterity. What are the benchmarks that you use, for instance, when you have to look at that? Because a lot of the future depends on what you do today.
On one hand, he has to be very wise in terms of allocating funds. But on the other hand, he has to enable growth. Because I think for a business, the biggest challenge for the business, and more so in the current timings, is growth. Because unless growth happens, you can't come out. I mean, profitability, you have to do business to become profitable and all that. Second is the competitiveness. So any investment that requires for you to enable growth or become competitive, which are a whole host of decision making around, say, innovation, investment, and all that stuff. And third thing today that we have seen is governance, means the whole decision making process.
Sure.
In the company, financial decision and business decisions have to be within the framework of governance, which brings into its ambit the whole of risk management process. And the governance has got completely new dimensions today, especially after this New Companies Act and the expectation of your investors, the way global investors look at you in terms of transparency of disclosures and all that stuff. So I say at any point in time, a CFO has to balance out these three basic drivers of business for future.
Mr. Gupta, I started off by saying that this kind of forum gives me a great sense of what CFOs are thinking. I must say, the one takeaway for me going away from here today is going to be that when CFOs start about talking about growth and innovation and not cost management and cutbacks, there is a turnaround that is happening. So let me ask you this. Is that also the new normal, where after the kind of volatility that we've gone through, we've realized that growth comes with challenges? And we've seen that happen, because growth meant many companies expanding across in terms of width and depth. Is the new normal recalibration of your own expectation of how the market will look?
Yeah, I think when we talk of the earlier period when people created more capacity and then they had a problem of dealing with downsides and all that, I think somewhere adequate risk analysis of growth was not done. And this is a continuous challenge. You don't want to scuttle growth, but you still want to address the risks associated with this. How to make it variable? Every industry has got different way to handle variability. And over a longer period, our effort always has been to remain flexible and have certain variability in our business model, which helps you address the downtrend. So it actually varies from industry to industry. Certain capital intensive industry may find it very difficult. Some technology driven industry like us may find it easier. So more and more deployment of technology which gives you scalability really helps you in dynamic planning of capacity, so that you don't end up taking we don't end up committing a large pool of cash on a particular assumption does not come true and you face difficulties. So there's no one solution to everybody. I mean, the solutions are different.
Manoj, is this the new age thinking with CFOs? Because traditionally, if you saw traditional Indian companies, it was all about, you know, being very, very particular about the P&L, making sure that we cut, you know, manage expenditure, manage costs. And very often it meant that you're looking at a very limited scale. Has that mindset?
I think it has changed. And, you know, very much to your point, the CFOs right now are in the frame of mind that where is my next, even a sales dollar going to come from? And how do I increase market access? What, you know, so they're thinking products, they're thinking distribution. It's very interesting how the role of the CFO is evolving.
Mr. Gupta, also does it mean that CFOs and CEOs work very, very closely in tandem? And there is an overlap out there?
Actually, it's a requirement of the business today. CEOs have got vision for the company in terms of growth, and CFOs have to share that vision. there is no question of having a different views about vision. Now, the challenge before CFO is to enable that vision to be realized, but on the other side, prepare adequately for the downsides. Means CEOs sometimes may only see the positive side, and downside, they expect CFO to take care of downside.
When so, it happens, figure it out.
No, actually they say even before it happens, you understand that and be in the state of readiness. Okay. So what if? So that's one analysis, that if CEO's plan and vision does not go as per his expectation, how are you going to deal with that situation when we talk of risk and uncertainty? I see that CEO's vision facing roadblocks is another uncertainty, which is the sole responsibility of CFO only, because this is what CEO expects from CFO.
Sure.
So whether it is the external environment, say your legal framework and all that, or whether all kind of business environments in terms of cost drivers and all that. So this is has to be done. There's no, I mean, there's no choices.
Ms. Sangeera, as a banker, you would have sat across the table with a lot of stressed out companies or companies looking for funds, and you would have dealt with CFOs. What is the biggest mistake that CFOs make, and what are the things that they should keep in mind if you were to look? Because often bankers have a great sense of this.
I'll say that we should not look at the mistakes CFOs, the corporates, who have made. We more need to look at the circumstances and how the economy is evolving.
Sure.
Because these are the circumstances which undergo a change, and then the projections go haywire. So that is the viewpoint with which we have to look at it. And in that changing circumstances, how we can monitor those accounts and how we can handhold those accounts. That is, I think, is the viewpoint we should have. And in my keynote address also, I mentioned that from the overall perspective of the organization also, CEO has to be associated with the changes and be the change itself. So that is how the evolving circumstances, and when these corporates are getting difficult times, how we can address their difficulties and how handhold them so that they should be able to come out of that. Because no CFO of a company would like to fail in his endeavors. It is the circumstance, and with the changing circumstances, we also have to address ourselves with those changes and be a part of, you can say, associating with them to come out of the difficulties.
Sure.
For long, a CFO has played a role of a value extractor, and now that role is changing from being a value extractor to a value driver. And by this, what I mean is that the CFO is one who's adopting a growth mindset to look at all the growth opportunities across the organization, look at innovation, and keep the management totally abreast with the changing market scenarios.
CFOs today are not only having the limited function of what CFOs were used to perform earlier. Now CFOs has to be very much alive to the what is happening and what are the present circumstances, and they have to be a very close confidant and close consultant of the CEOs. Because whatever decisions the CEOs have to take in the present day context according to the changing environment and the changes which keep on happening, the CFOs immediately have to respond to that and have to be very pragmatic to the business opportunities coming in the way of the CEOs.